All right, here's three. What's the names? Name? Pangalan. What's your name?
Is it Pangalan?
Rosalyn.
Rosalyn.
Rosalyn and
Johnny.
Johnny?
Rodil.
Rodil, okay. Okay, there's three over here now. Three. Okay, three in this is the. Hey, this is Brother Patrick. I'm here in the orphanage, and this is the old house, but the new orphanage. And then the other one is the new house, but the old orphanage. So, that's his three new orphans, and they're here. They already said their names. Rosalyn, Johnny.
Johnny and Rodil.
Rodil, okay. And if you guys have already seen, if you've been watching my videos when we have the Christmas party, and all of that, you saw Ramel. As I've told you, he's my brother-in-law. He made the swing set. And if you've been following the videos, we've been talking about that we would make an orphanage here as when the other one was full. So I wanted to show, because I've already been talking about the plan, we're going to put another bedroom on this house over here in the corner. And we're going to go ahead and start trying to build a wall around the whole property. So it's probably going to cost... At least, our estimate is it's going to be about $10,000 to put a wall that's like 8 or 9 feet high around the whole property, cinder block and cement. But we're just going to start by building the new rooms into the wall, you know, and start those sections of the wall for now. Get that going. So I'm going to put a bedroom right here in this corner of the lot and connect it right in here into this other bedroom, or into this is the living room of the old house. And then we're going to put right here what I was telling you guys, what we call a dirty kitchen. I'll show you on the other house. It's an outdoor kitchen and then probably two bathrooms in this back corner of the lot. And then we'll also put make the firewall there. As a matter of fact, we want to put the dirty kitchen here, but maybe I can talk them into putting the dirty kitchen there and making the firewall. But I don't know. We don't want to mess up our trees. So we will see. So I'm just touring the property here. As you can see, we've got this, a lot of you guys like this. If you come visit, you can go up there and stay in this thing. We call this a bahakubo, or it's like a rest house. So we can put you in there, let you stay when you visit. And anyway, let me just keep walking around here. This is where we have our chickens and stuff. And this is where we used to have a little grocery store. Remember, one time we had like a little grocery store here. And then we shut that down because the people want to keep getting a loan and not paying it back. And there's our turkeys. If you can hear our turkeys, I guess with this thing, I guess you can't zoom when you're recording on this thing. I thought you could. I guess not. See, we got some turkeys. They're over here in this area. And then over here we have our chickens. That's our chicken coop. And then we had a whole lot more chickens around here. You know what? Our neighbor, they gave their chickens some immunizations. And then, of course, you know, immunizations are really actually bad because all of our chickens got sick and died from the vaccines. So, anyway, this is the area that used to be, when we bought this place, they had pigs and stuff in here and goats. And I guess we're going to end up tearing this down. Maybe, and I don't know, we've had some goats and pigs and on and off, and then we ate them and sold them and whatnot. We have some more chickens here. This is to the other, we're getting to the line really to the other orphanage. So we have some chickens over here too. And you can see there's the van. We've got the van here that we talked about. Maybe we can get them to open the van and we can look in. We can open the van and look inside and see the van. Like I say, we ended up paying about $9,000 for it. Hey, do you guys remember, if you're used to the videos, you remember when we had I made the one where there are people trying to break in here and stuff? Well, we got these two mangy barking dogs. One to guard the pigs. We have a couple of pigs in this area. You see they got it kind of fenced off here. We've got a dog. They've got a killer dog in there. And then we have another dog that's on the other side that I guess he's asleep right now. Anyway, so let's look at the van. Now on this house here, let's look at the van first. This is the van. Okay. going to see inside. It's pretty big. 14. It's a really nice van. Like I said, it's a 2007. He paid about 9,000. Paid about 9,000 U.S. dollars for it. So thanks to all the donors and everyone that's helping us buy it. I really appreciate that a lot. And you know, we really need it. As a matter of fact, I guess we're going to have to get a second one if the orphans keep showing up here. That the Lord keeps providing. I'm going to show them more of the orphans in a minute. Here's the back of the vehicle, so you guys can get an idea about it. Like I said, that's one of our killer attack dogs, so we won't have any more break-ins. Now see, I'm in front of the new house, the old orphanage, looking back at the other house. So you can see the lot. It's about a half acre lot we have here. So here's the old orphanage, or the new house. You guys come outside. Go us. Mo. Come here. Come on. Pagdali. Come on. All right, I'm trying to get them. They're hiding and peeping on me, but I wanted to get the new orphans and their names and stuff. And the old ones that you guys already know, who are so famous, like Joni. It's the original one. Okay. They're coming over here. All right. What's up, Pangalan mo? What's their names? What's their name? He's so.
Singalan dali niyo. Singalan ni mo kano.
Oh, we know you. Hey. Hey. John May.
Lino.
Oi, balik diri.
Hey, what's your name?
Lino. Kano, Lino.
Lino?
Yeah.
And yeah. We know this. What's Queen?
Lovely Queen.
Lovely Queen. Earl. John Ray.
Lito.
What's his name? Lilo. Lito. Okay. Hey, how are you? Make a video. This camera's so hot. So anyway, of course, can enjoy the wind and the dog barking. You can get the real experience of the Philippines. There's always barking dogs and chickens. Here comes some more. So there's love. What's his name? Gmar? And there's Joni. I don't know why Joni can't come here. She keeps walking around. Hey, Joni. Joanne. In America, they say Joni, not Joanne. Okay. Say hello. Say thank you for the van. Thank you for the salamat. Thank you for the van.
Thank you.
You're speaking Bisaya.
Thank you, Savan. Okay, ready, go.
There says,
thank you, Savan.
Okay.
Car.
Yeah, it's a car, but it's a car and a van. It's a van. Thank you for the van. Yes.
Thank you for the van. Savan, ready, go.
Thank you for the van.
Oh, you're welcome.
Bye-bye.
Okay, I just want to get all you guys. So, the other ones, where's the other ones? The other orphans are coming.
This afternoon we're going to get the two in Matanao.
Okay.
There's two. And next week we'll be going to get some orphans.
Okay. Where's Michael and...
Inside.
Oh, there's some... Yeah. I know there's more orphans around here somewhere.
Yeah.
We've got a total of like 20, but some of them are around here somewhere, as you heard. There's two that I guess they went to visit their relatives that we're going to pick up tomorrow, that they're visiting their grandparents. So that's the thing about the orphans. They want to go visit their grandparents or let them go for the weekend, things like that. You know, we're trying to keep them in contact with their families and stuff. Right on this building, this is what they call a dirty kitchen right here. I'm going to show you. See this right here? This is our dirty kitchen. I know I've taken a picture. I might have made a video. Anyway, this is what we want to build on the other house. One like this. See, so it's partially We need to cover over this cement so it'll last longer too. And then this is the design so it's more cool. And we've got a wood stove in there actually. You can just see it. You can't really see it. There's a wood stove. And let me go in the house. And we're going to build this on the other house. And then our bathrooms that we made, they didn't really make them up to a good standard. See, I'll show it to you. We want to make it. Those are the bathrooms. Now, these are already good by Filipino standards, guys, believe it or not. These are way good. As you're going to see, this is the bathrooms that they use. See how small is that toilet? If any of you guys visit here, you're going to have trouble unless you're, say, under 30 or maybe 40. You'll have trouble trying to use these bathrooms. They're so low to the ground. Now, what you see here is this is a standard. This is better than the average Filipino's bathroom. This is already high class right here. In or outside the big cities like Manila or something. Or in the poor areas of Manila, they even use the bathroom in the river too, even in the city. Anyway, so we're going to, here we're going to build another bedroom. And we're going to try to make it a nicer bathroom and stuff, especially if any of you guys visit. We're going to make a mission house here. A nice bedroom with a nice bathroom here, by the grace of God. So the house parents will be using it. We'll have it connected to this dirty kitchen right here, in this area right here. And then if any of you guys come, of course you can stay in it. We'll have a little window unit air conditioner. You know, we need to have if you come here from the U.S., especially in the winter time, and you're talking about going to 100 degrees a day, you will never be able to sleep without air conditioning, I guarantee it. With these dogs barking and the chickens, let me tell you, I've been living here 7 years, I can tell you. Something that takes years to get used to. Anyway, here's, I'm going to go inside and we'll look at the rest of the orphans. You guys are just looking at me. My camera's hot. Let's go inside. We're going to see.
Mark Michael is sleeping and maybe join.
Okay.
In the middle room.
She's your helper?
Yeah. She's 15 years old.
Oh, so she's only.
She's kind of.
Okay. What's her name?
Angelica.
Angelica. She's 15 and she's in the fourth grade. She's included really in the orphanage.
Yeah, I want her, but I need to ask her mother first.
Okay.
Her mother goes to Roman's church.
Okay.
She's the one of our feeding in village before.
Right. Okay. She's going to try to get her here. Her mom is so.
Yeah, I will ask the mom.
Okay. Well, yeah. Ask you guys to pray that the mother of Angelica, she's 15 and in the fourth grade, that she can come here and finish her school and be, she can be an orphan / helper because she's already 15, so it will be a benefit for her and for all the other kids in the house, mom and dad.
She's the result of our feeding before.
I'm going to, they're asleep. I'm just going to now I just want to get a picture of, that's her two, let it focus. That's our two smallest ones. That's Michael and Joy. Baby Joy. So that's our two youngest members here in the orphanage. And of course, you know that that's Laura, the daughter of the house mom and dad. She loves to be in attention, but she's pretending like she's shy right now. anyway, brothers and sisters, I showed you the additions of what we're going to make. I think the people that have already been donating for that, like I said, we've got enough money to get rolling with it and get a rough finish, it looks like. And then, of course, as whatever budget we have, the amount of money we have, the nicer we'll make it. You know, whatever, the more durable we'll make it. We can make it cheap, but, you know, the how long it'll last is also connected to how much you spend, right? You know, here's our wooden stove, and we're going to make one like this. It's got like a firebox in it and stuff, and then we're going to make one like this in the other house for the other orphanage. The same similar layout here, and then a bedroom in each house. But in this one, I'm going to make, like I said, I want to make the bedroom a little nicer so that if you guys visit, you can stay in there and enjoy it. And then here's the back area. I've talked about this before. Now, this land was for sale, but they wanted way too much for it. But maybe let's pray, Because there's lots of land around here that's just like used for cows and stuff. And I already wanted to buy it before, but the price they wanted was like $5,000 for a half acre. That's just too much. But now that I think about it, maybe we should have bought it. Because, you know, orphanage is kind of jammed up with all these kids. A half acre's not that big. Anyway, there's two quarter acre lots behind us that are just fields. On the side of us, there's a half acre that's just a field. All the land around us is only field, except for up there on the front corner up there by the old house, the original house. There's a little house on the corner. But all around us, all but one little corner is all open land that's just used for cows and stuff. So we could get this land, brothers and sisters. I ask you to pray that we'll have the finances, and number two, that the price will be lower. You know, God will give us favor, that they'll, you know, want to sell it fast. I mean, people sell their land for frivolous reasons sometimes. You know, they want to buy a car. They, you know, they don't really need it. Maybe their kid is getting married and they want to have a big celebration. They'll sell their land for that, whatever. You know, God can make a way. So anyway, guys, I'm going to cut this off because it's already getting pretty long. God bless you guys. Love you guys. And I'll be putting some pictures on the Facebook and stuff of the orphans, okay? Bye.